tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats. You cannot be serious. It's Fred Serious. Stand Up Girls. It's Judy Love. And Rob Beckett, their team captain. And facing them tonight, your Mish is our command. It's Mish Kumar. Ask for questions. It's Natasha Dimitriou and Harry Godleman, their guest team captain. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, 3 in 10 pet owners sign their animal's name in cards? It's fun in a birthday card, less appropriate in a card which reads, "Sorry for your loss, lots of love, Mr. Mittens." Snails have approximately 25,000 teeth, so a snail might be Rob's real dad. It's especially good because my teeth are so natural. And 63% of people say they'd be comfortable with a gay monarch, so it doesn't matter if it's queen and country or queen and penis-y. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. With all the Brexit stuff going on, we thought we'd ask the nation the best things Europe has given us. Rob's team, what do you think are the best things Europe's given us?
I mean, food's got to be up there.
Do you like European food? What's your favourite European food?
I'm not a big fan of European food. I prefer British food.
What sort of thing?
Nando's, Café Rouge, ZZ's.
Proper stuff, isn't it?
Yeah, proper stuff.
European food, what do you think?
Pizzas aren't real food anyway. That's a cheese and tomato toasty. Mediterranean food is the kind of food you eat when you can't be asked to cook.
That's because you can't cook.
Yeah.
that is true.
Neither can you just put people in seats.
It's a good way he's got you there.
I mean, it's true, it's a fair point. I'm not a good cook.
Are you not a good cook?
Tapas, I don't understand, because that's not enough. Is that Spanish for not enough?
We haven't made enough of that. Have some of that.
No, we'll need more. We're going to need more. And when, in this country, we celebrate big portions, don't we?
Yes.
Not tiny, tiny portions. Like, we were like, people boast about going somewhere where you could, all you could eat.
All you could eat.
All you could eat. So tapas doesn't work.
You've not had Greek food, have you?
I have had Greek food.
Well, that's like, if you come to my house on my dad's Greek.
There's loads.
Oh, there's a pig. There's a pig and a goat and a whole farm. It's got a spit.
Little.
Like old MacDonald, yeah. Just with a line through it.
Listen, Jimmy, just between you and me, right, I've said some real bad stuff about Brexit because I think it's a really bad idea. And I'm a bit worried now that it's happening, they're going to deport me. So, I basically need to roll some of that back. Leave means leave. I hate all European food. I just want to eat sausage and mash and fish and chips. And I just want it to get all bunged up in my bowels. And I just want to feel blockages because there should be no freedom of movement, whether it's goods and people across the border or feces coming out of my anus.
Can we just take a moment there to enjoy the punchline, feces coming out of my anus? Harry, what do you think?
No disrespect, but too many cheeses in France.
What did you mean? Cheese?
We've got cheddar, we've got the orange one.
We've got Dairy Lee.
Dairy Lee, cheese string.
Laughing
cow. The one with the cow, yeah.
Quavers.
Quavers.
We don't need all the other ones.
Brexit means Brexit.
OK, so, French food, do you eat any European foods, Judy? What's your favourite?
OK, so I like pizza, I like Italians.
Well, where do you stand on a calzone?
On a calzone?
A calzone, a folded pizza.
Oh, everything on me is folded, so I really ain't got no complaints.
So, the Italian language can be a little bit difficult. There's some tricky pronunciations. Let's take a look at an Italian man gallantly persevering with the pronunciation of a British kitchen classic.
We gotta use this one drop of one star shusha. We gotta use this one just shusha. One just star shine. Yeah, one just shine. One just shishara. One just shush. Shusha. Battle of the truth. I don't know what kind of the country come this from, but I'm Italian. I don't know what I gotta say. It's written in Italian now. Worcestershire. Sauce.
Yeah.
Can I ask? I mean, he said he was Italian, but that's your dad, right?
That is my dad. Well, the thing is, so my dad was a chef, and there was a time where he was a really good cook, but then something happened, I think laziness, and the stuff he cooks now, it's me and my brother call it, like, filthy delicious. This is not a lie. The other day, we were like, what are you going to have for dinner, Dad? And he was like, I'm going to treat myself, get something a little bit special, just something ready-made. I'm going to get a quiche and have some chippies with it. He accidentally mistook a quiche for a chocolate tart. So he cooked a Sara Lee chocolate tart with chips and was like, that, something's wrong. The egg is very bad in this quiche.
OK, well, I'm starting to understand why the Greek economy is ruined. Now, we all like pizza, right? We all like pizza. There's some unusual ways of eating it. Take a look at this.
I'm glad he turned around. I thought it was just going straight through the back of his head. Passing it through.
Could you do that?
I could do that.
Oh my god, that's massive!
I don't like. Hang on.
Oh my.
Is this like a proper Italian?
I think someone's left it in the garden, Jim.
You're taking the veg off. Oh, you are so South London.
If it was any good, they would have chopped it up and put it in the sauce. So what have I got to try and get that in one.
Right. Oh, my God.
Oh, hang on.
Oh,
I think he can do it.
It's like watching a cow birth in reverse.
I could do extra work on Emmerdale. You can't afford a real cow. Come here, give me the pizza.
Your wife is so lucky, Rob.
My eyes started watering. I mean, yeah. I have a newfound respect for certain activities.
British food, like, there's a restaurant in Paris, isn't there, where it's British cuisine?
That's right. And lots of Italians, Greek, French, jerk restaurants.
It's such a lovely accent. You just do anything for it.
Can you say
anything.
Aubergine?
Anything.
Aubergine.
Oh, for God's sake.
Can you say, I regret to tell you that we're going to have to put your dog down?
Je suis désolé de vous dire, mais on va devoir tuer votre chien.
Do it! Put it down!
Do it! Do you know what?
Take it.
Throw it in the canal.
Gorgeous. I'm going to get a dog so you can put it down.
Sorry, throw it in the canal. What vets are you using, Jimmy?
The one next to the canal. Right, let's see if food is up there. Yes, it's European food. European food is incredibly varied. Whether you want to have the shits, the squits, the squirts, or the skitters, there's something for everyone. OK, let's test how well you know your European delicacies. Rob, Judy, let's go and play the European Food Challenge.
Oh, OK. Come on.
Right, OK. Here we go. OK, it's the cat's taste test, so blindfolds on.
It's like one of your dinner parties, Jim. Blindfolds on. It's his house, we do what he says.
You've seen Eyes Wide Shut?
No, just that the last time I put blindfolds on and put something in my mouth, I got pregnant. So I'm just...
OK, Rob, you are first. You've got to tell me what this is and what country it's from, OK?
You're putting it in?
Yep.
It's just hang on.
Open wide, no, open wide. No, you're fine.
I thought I had another 10 years till the jungle.
Oh. That's...
Oh, so you gave me a lot then. It's like a German sausage, isn't it?
Oh.
Yeah, Frankfurter from Germany, yes. Oh. OK. Judy, you're up next. All right, just open wide. Take a bite.
It's a bit cheesy. I wonder if this is what Fred tastes like.
OK. Judy, what do you think? What is that?
Some kind of cheese.
Some kind of cheese. From where?
From... what's his called place?
France?
Yeah.
France. You needed a clue for France. OK, that's French époisse. OK, right. So this one.
Is it me?
You ready? Yeah, OK. Oh. Hang on. Oh. Yeah.
I can't get it through these. What is this? Oh. Tastes like flesh.
I don't like people with weird laughs.
It tastes like raw bacon.
Oh, oh, I'll give you that. It's Romanian sallow cured back fat. Okay, Judy, open your mouth. Okay, wide. Okay, I'll do a little spoon. There
oh.
you go.
Oh my God,
what do you think, Judy?
Hmm.
Well, you turned on a sixpence there, didn't you?
Is there any more? I just need to taste it again.
Yeah, there is. Okay.
What is it? You like it, though, don't you, Jude?
I did. Could you tell from the way I was clapping my lips?
Yeah, yeah. You are not in any favour escape them lips, are you?
All this waste. Oh.
OK, what do you think?
I think it's like pickled cabbage or something.
Yes, I'll give you that. It's sauerkraut. OK, Rob, you got the most right. A big round of applause for Rob and Judy. Right. OK. Kerry, what do you think? What else have the Europeans given us?
They've given us art and things like that. Culture. Ooh. Culture. They gave culture. Us culture.
From the Greeks to the Italians to the French.
Yeah, and we don't need it anymore after Brexit. We've got the British Museum that's full of stuff that was stolen by British people.
My dad cried when he went to the British Museum.
Why? Because he saw all his stuff.
All the stolen things.
Europe's given us an awful lot of incredible culture over the years. I'm sure you're all familiar with the different kinds of music from around Europe. Take a look at this Tyrolean choir. It's an area of Austria. Rather unique and rousing performance here.
Netflix documentary about serial killers.
It looked to me like it was sort of a lineup like Usual Suspects of sex offenders, and the twist is they all did it. So let's get other elements of European
yeah, come
culture.
On, move on. Move
art,
on.
Loads of paintings. Dali, Picasso, Van Gogh.
Van Gogh.
Well, what yeah. would we wouldn't have the scream emoji if it wasn't.
Mona Lisa.
Right. I wouldn't bother queuing 5 hours to see the Mona
no.
Lisa. Apparently, it used to hang on the wall of Napoleon's bedroom, didn't it? Because he used yeah. to sort of revel in her beauty, which is code for wank too.
Revel in her beauty is a lovely expression, though. I was on YouPorn last night, reveling in some of the ladies' beauty.
I always get a bit frustrated by you know, the statues of normally naked men. It's great, but they always get the knob wrong.
Have you ever seen a European willy, though? Because my memory of my dad's willy from growing up, honestly... I just realised what that sounded like.
Your dad's knob, paint us a picture.
And then he's like, you know, he's very hairy because he's Mediterranean, so it's like a lovely, thick sort of black hair around it, but a bit sort of crispy, so it's like old hair.
Mm. Yeah.
Does it look a bit like, you know, like a mini egg in a cornflake cupcake?
Exactly! Exactly. Thank you, Rob.
So would you say the statues are actually quite complimentary?
Yes, honestly. Whenever there's a willy missing, because I think a lot of the willies have gone on those statues, haven't they?
Hindus.
Okay, let's see if it's up there. Yes, European culture. 6 million visitors see the Mona Lisa in Paris every year. If I want to see a miserable woman looking disappointed, I could just stay home and have sex. That's it for part one. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 Out of 10 Cats, where we're still trying to guess the top three things the Europeans have given us. OK, fingers on buzzers. What do you think, Rob?
I think it might be fashion.
Fashion?
You're a pretty well-dressed guy.
Yeah, fashion, yeah.
The way French and Italians always are very smart, don't they?
All the fashion houses, they're all European, aren't they? So it's Paris Fashion Week,
yeah.
Milan,
yeah.
It's big on fashion.
Croydon Fashion Week.
Croydon Fashion Week.
But why is it that they're all the most amazing? Because I agree, obviously amazing fashion houses, yeah, in Europe, but then I feel like European fashion on the whole is very, like, a lovely tight bootcut jean, little tight tank top on a man.
Yeah. People are very dismissive of the catwalk. They just say, oh, these models, they make a fortune just walking up and down. But it's not always easy. Have a look. Oh, this is so wonderful. Oh, look at this. Look at the legs. Oh, oh, no, it's all right. I'm going to be all right. I've got it. Oh, ah, ah. Oh, oh, ah. Whoa. This is a joy. Oh. It's OK, she's got it. Don't worry about that.
Don't drop the water in, can.
And she's off. Oh.
Oh. Almost.
This next one really delivers. This one's, it's got kind of a double bubble here. Yeah. Whoa. Don't worry. Don't worry. I'm coming. I'm coming. I'll get you. Don't worry. I've got you. Whoa. Isn't this easy?
The thing is, you don't need to see that on a fashion catwalk. You can see that any Saturday night in any market town, yeah, in this country.
The catwalk is not an easy thing. So what I'm going to do, catwalk challenge, Rob, Kerry, why don't you just both walk down and do that, you know, that turn to the camera. You're going to do blue steel into the camera and then turn and walk away.
You just, yeah, have to look really pissed off, don't,
yeah,
you?
Yes. OK, all right, here's the music. Go.
Yeah.
Oh, look at him.
Yeah.
Go.
Yeah. Oh.
Fantastic by you, lot of swagger. I mean, the look of shock on your face. Can we have a look at the shock on his face again there? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Well, like I said, fashion is not one of the top three things, but my top fashion tip, horizontal stripes can make you look fat, especially if they're the stripes in Viennetta, lasagna and Victoria sponge. OK, fingers on buzzers. What else has Europe given us?
Eurovision.
Yes.
Eurovision, of course. Before we even get into talking about Eurovision, shall we treat ourselves to some clips?
Because, oh, yes.
It is magnificent. God. Let's remind ourselves of the classic Eurovision entry by the Ukraine in 2007.
Basically, Eurovision, like, can go, can't it? Like, that should go. If we've only got 12 years left on the planet, I think we should have been all of Eurovision.
Hang on, this is a waste. What a terrible way to hear. We've got 12 years left.
We only enjoy it ironically. No one's enjoying it sincerely, are they?
Is it why we voted leave then? Because of the Eurovision?
Well, I wouldn't be surprised, because it's all shit.
All apart from the Polish entry in 2014, which was brilliant. I don't, Fred, I don't speak any Polish, but I presume that song is called Sling It Up Me. Natasha, are you a fan of Eurovision?
I absolutely love it. My favourite about Eurovision, though, is, you know, when they're at the end where they cut to have all the different countries in their booths with flags and you just know it stinks of farts and cheese and onion crisps.
I like it when they do the scores and you basically get to see every country Stephen Mulhern. He turns up like, hello, guys! He's a guy from Lisbon and it's me! Their little moments, so big.
Well, if you must, if you...
Oh! Nish, have you ever watched it?
No! It's about 17 hours long.
So why are you all so miserable? It's so
Listen, if I want to see someone singing badly, I'll just go down to the Milan bar in East Croydon.
Well, I can tell you that Eurovision is not in our top three. OK, fingers on buzzers. One more thing to get.
Could it be... Like package holidays, going to Europe for holidays.
Have you been on a package holiday?
Have I been on a package holiday, mate? The worst bit for me on a package holiday was when you're on the coach. Basically, you have to play hotel bingo. Right, there's two. Well, one is sometimes you don't even know what hotel you're going to. Back in the day, you didn't. You just got recommended ones. So you pull up outside and going, oh, please, no. And then they announce it, you go, oh, yeah, these losers are going, yes! And the worst one is always one dickhead on the coach, and you just like, oh, please don't be on mine. Please don't be on mine. Because the worst is holiday friends.
Oh.
And then when someone wants to be your mate, and then you say, oh, leave me. I've got mates at home I don't like. I don't need another pair.
I only went on my first all-inclusive quite recently. I've always been a bit snobby about an all-inclusive. No disrespect, Rob.
Oh.
Right. But now I've been on one because you get a wristband and it gives you power. Like
what?
You yes. When you've got a wristband, you
are
can
you gonna punch
yes.
Me?
You can have everything. Yeah. So by the like within a day, I was like under the ice cream, giving the kids cocktails. I was mainlining fizzy wine. Give a wristband.
You can't commit a crime either. Just so it gets hidden away. It's all
exactly.
That work.
I'm on a gold band. I can do what I want.
What's gold band?
No, like when you get invited to a wedding, but you've only been invited to the disco. Yeah. That's like, that's blue band.
Right.
But if you've been invited to the whole shindig, gold band, mate. You can do what you like.
Eat what you want.
I've been to a lot of Indian weddings, and so if you get invited to the whole day, that's normal. And if you get invited to just the evening, that means that you're white.
Does that mean that holidays are going to be more of a challenge, like going abroad? So we're going to have more British holidays?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
I mean, it's packing for a British holiday that's a massive pain, isn't it? Because you need to pack for every season. So you've got to put a gagoule in, flip-flops, snow boots, visor, factor 50, galoshes.
The only good thing about, like, if package holidays become a thing of the past is we'll avoid the sunbed thing, having to get the right sunbed. Mm. Yeah. That could be a nightmare. Take a look at this footage.
Here he goes. And they're on the starters orders. He's going to clap, and the whole swarm of them, they're off. Look at that. How mad that this is. Just like ants. I've never seen anything like it. We're all watching it, because we're all horrified that we've had to do this every day on holiday, Lella. This has ruined my holiday.
The problem is, with a package holidays, there's always a geezer that's been there a bit longer than you. And they call you going, what you want to do is you go to that bit of the beach, get an ice cream from that place there, dinner, get there at 8:15. That's when it's fresh. It's been restocked. You get there at 6, it's fresh, but who eats at 6? The Spanish eat at 10, the mad bastards. And I'm like, mate, you literally got it 12 hours before me. Like...
But you know what? What's funny, I think, for us as British, when we go to other countries, the first thing, the priority for us is to find out which restaurant and cafe does British food. That's what it is. Not where the hospitals are, do you know what I mean? Not what my room looks
like.
Who
arrives on holiday and goes, right, where are the hospitals? OK, let's have a look and see if it's up there. Yes, it's package holidays. Resorts like Magaluf have become a mixture of different cultures. For instance, the most popular breakfast is a croissant washed down with a pint of Zambuca and the morning after pill. At the end of that round, I can tell you, Rob's team are in the lead. That's it for part two. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 Out of 10 Cats. Our next round is Pick of the Polls. Rob, Judy, Fred, What do you like the look of?
Oh, well, I quite like the look of old Freddy.
So, Fred, you present First Date. So we asked our studio audience, would you go on a blind date?
I've never been on a blind date, but I did take my mum to Nando's after she had a detached retina operation.
Judy.
I would go on a blind date.
Have you been on
a blind date?
I've
been on a blind date before. His name was Adam, but when I turned up, he looked like Amanda. And I had a lucky escape because I just walked away because obviously he was expecting someone called Lindsay with blonde hair.
It's quite nice because there's no investment, isn't it? Like, you don't know the person. If you don't like them, you're never going to see them again. So you can just go, right, you're not a keeper, so don't speak because I want to enjoy my dinner. It's rare I get a night away from my husband.
Natasha.
I've never been on a date. I've been on one date and I was 20, I think I was like 23, and I was so nervous that I said I was 17. And he
was, and he was like, going on a date with R. Kelly?
No, but he was...
Have you been on Tinder? Have you ever been on Tinder?
I have, but the only thing I did on it was have, like, really disgusting, sexy conversations with really, really weird men.
How was it weird?
We're just being like, I'm a little mouse and I want some butter.
OK, well, I'm made of questions right now. You're a little mouse and you want some butter. Any other
just
examples?
So many weird... I really were just like, do you want to come and nibble on my bread tits? Are you a little rat like me? Squeak, squeak. And, you know, it was very, like, rodent-based. And then you just realise you're on your own on a Sunday afternoon in bed being like... This one man was like, I'm going to come, where are you? And I said, where are you? And he said, Tesco's.
Cilla Black must be turning in her flipping grave.
Fred, is there any hope for Natasha?
I don't know, actually.
And he believes in, like, love.
The world is very big.
Like my panties, but listen...
I met my husband through a blind date.
Really?
I did.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I wasn't on the blind date with him. I went on a blind date because I'd been single for quite a long time, so I'd gone a bit feral. And someone set me up on a blind date, and I went on the blind date, and it was shit. But he introduced me to my now husband.
Oh.
I do think it's a nice idea in a blind date. You might find romance through that
person. Yeah, see, it's an opportunity to network.
Yes, it's networking, absolutely.
Nish, have you dating history once?
Oh, you know, Jimmy, I have kissed my fair share of women. Brackets three. I was Mr. French at university. French kissing.
You know you have to do your tongue for French kissing. It's not.
What?
It's very much about. It's like being in an Austrian choir. That's the best preparation you can have.
No, I mean, listen. It's a miracle that I ever managed to sexualize any lady.
Well, I mean, when you speak like that, you really feel
it's like
a
Ted Bundy confession.
Okay, blind dates can be awkward. Take a look at this amazing moment from First Dates in New Zealand.
How old are you?
I'm 24.
Oh, okay.
How old are you?
I'm 19.
Oh, you're 19. Oh, okay. You look older. Like more mature. Not as in like you know.
Yeah. So can you act?
Yeah.
All right. Act like a really arrogant. Cocky guy.
Yeah.
You know, I just rooted two girls last night.
Oh, okay.
Kind of like.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Hi, nice to meet you.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
I love tits in my face. Oh.
You don't.
Oh, Rob.
I'm with him.
Who don't? You make an absolutely valid point.
Yeah, you can question his delivery, but I think the truth's there.
You don't say it early doors on a date, though.
It's not an opener, is it? Oh, do you fancy a starter? I like tits in my face. OK, so we asked our studio audience, would you ever go on a blind date? What do you think?
Yeah.
Yes.
These people. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, I can tell you. The answer is yes. 56% of our studio audience would go on a blind date. On the 90s TV show Blind Date, you chose a person based on the sound of their voice. Silly, really. Now we have Naked Attraction, where you just pick your favourite cock and balls. So at the end of that round, it's 3 points for Rob's team, 2 points for Carrie's team. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top superpower people wish they had. What do you think?
I wish I was invisible.
What would you do if you were invisible?
Go to Fred's house.
And what would you do?
I don't even want to say.
If you'd like to hear the end of this, it'll be on some sort of fan fiction website. Okay, top superpower, what do you think?
I'd like to suddenly be white. Like, sometimes you go to parts of the country and everyone's looking at you and you just like to be able to press a button and be like, hi, Nick Cooper. I work in accounts and wear red socks. Let's play bridge.
I went out with him.
What about, like, if you could have boiling water coming out the end of a digit to make a cup of tea?
It's more convenience power. Yeah,
and then everyone would be like, give it through the water.
God's sake, all right.
Yeah, but it'd be true if you were invisible. People would be like, go on, do
it. No, but you don't tell anyone.
You don't tell anyone you're invisible.
I'd love to be invisible, but I wouldn't do anything. I'll just lay on my sofa at home and be left alone.
You wouldn't do anything?
Yeah, I'd just lay there and not be told to do anything, are
I? Oh, I can imagine the thing you would do. You'd go around.
Go where?
Go around in this audience.
Doing what?
You'd be doing stuff.
I know what you mean, Fred. Really, the question is, if I was invisible, what is the second thing I would do? They think the ladies' changing rooms were haunted.
You did do that, right? Like, which is obviously very creepy, but when you're invisible, you can still bump into people. It's after a while, they were like, something's wrong in that changing room. I keep falling over.
Yeah. And just every so often, we hear,
Natasha, what superpower would you have?
If I could work out some sort of superpower where I didn't have to go to the toilet anymore, I could just, like, ingest it somehow without it poisoning me. I just need it all the time. I'm a toilet woman. Like, I honestly... I wake up in the morning sometimes and I think, today isn't about what I have to do, it's where my piss wants to go.
That's called a urine infection, babes.
My dad, I was at home for Christmas and I came on my period and my mum was like, can you go out and get, when you go to the shops, can you get some Sancho Stash? And he brought me back Tenor Lady. Because he just saw them. But honestly, the best thing I've ever been given.
The best gift I've ever received.
So he bought them by mistake and you just leant into it and went, well, I'll use these.
Well, it was just like... You can't fully let go because it's too scary, but you can a little bit.
You didn't just let it all hang out.
But when it's like, oh, I'll just let that out and then I'll have some time before I have to run.
There is a fine line between just a little bit and self-loathing.
I haven't got anyone. I'm not in a relationship. What do I bloody want?
I think I wouldn't give up my power to use... I do a lot of my best thinking on the toilet. I have sit-down wheeze. I don't mind admitting to it.
Really... Oh, come on!
Did you hear that? They were more... Jay judged you more than...
Let's press pause on all this. What do you mean you have sit-down wee?
Sometimes I have a sit-down wee. Why? I treat myself to a sit-down... Because I'm not an animal. Treat myself to a sit-down wee. Why should ladies have all the fun?
I do that too. That's right, because you don't have to concentrate.
Exactly.
You just sit down and you relax, and that is...
Concentrate?
I don't need to concentrate. It is hard having a wee, because, like, I don't know, like... I mean, don't get into mechanics, but first thing in the morning, try and have a piss. It's a night, it goes everywhere.
No, you have to aim.
It's like the mouth of your dick's yawning. Oh, fuck it.
Yeah, and sometimes he goes like that. He goes like that.
Oh, I can't do that. I think that's a French thing. Sometimes on a night out, you know when there's like 15 in a row, I'll try and piss in all of them. But hold it and go.
Has someone ever walked in as you're doing a weird crab walk across?
Yeah, but you've just got to own it. You go, mind out, mate, I'm doing the full set.
Well, I don't know if anyone remembers, quite a long time ago, but we were talking about the top superpower. Quite some time ago. OK, let's get some answers on this. Top superpower.
Is it invisibility?
Absolutely right. Yes, the top superpower people wish they had is invisibility. I don't know if it's technically a superpower, but growing up, Rob Beckett was bitten by a radioactive beaver. That's it for part three. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 Out of 10 Cats, and the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your question. Worst way to spend a Saturday night?
Is it getting a lift home from Ant after Saturday Night Takeaway?
Come on, you know we love him. You know we love him.
It's a bit of fun, isn't it? Don't you dare, actually. That man has given us so many years of his life. He has entertained me more than so many people.
There's a young woman that doesn't go out on a Saturday night.
No.
It's exhausting going out.
If you were going out with your other half, where would you go? What's your go-to Saturday night date night?
Well, you don't have to go out anymore, do you? Because you've got, like, Netflix and you've got Deliveroo, which is like Meals on Wheels, and I can just sit on a commode. I don't need to go anywhere.
the most depressing thing there is not I can sit on a commode, but Deliveroo is like Meals on Wheels. Yeah. It's such a... Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I've got the internet. I don't need to go out, and you can get messy on a night in. You don't need to go out. You can
get... Be really careful. Your drinking mime as well needs a little bit of work.
Is the worst way to spend Saturday night watching your soon-to-be ex-wife perform on Strictly?
Oh, it must be, yeah. Ooh. That is so dark and true, but yeah. I always think that must be the worst conversation.
Please be Anton Dubec. Please be Anton Dubec. Not one of the massive fit ones.
I've had a couple of friends say, oh, my wife's going on Strictly.
And you're like...
Oh, right. Ugh. Fucking hell.
I think the worst way to spend a Saturday night is to look at your reflection in the mirror and wonder which part of you should shave first.
Yes, Judy. Finally, some relatable content for me.
Ethnics.
And Natasha, worst Saturday night?
It's tonight, it's Saturday. No.
So, Nish, what's the worst Saturday night you've ever had?
Oh, I mean, let's be real. I grew up in Croydon, so, I mean, you guys have got no idea. Until you've stood at the bus stop outside the Tiger Tiger and watched a man be so drunk in the street that he vomits into a box of chips and then carries on eating them.
It was my stag do!
Oh. Rob.
I've seen someone get fingered in a kebab shop.
Oh. It was my hen do!
Do you know what, Rob? Don't call it their kebab shop.
When I was growing up, the worst was when my mum used to have an Ann Summers party. And they're downstairs cackling, and you're upstairs just hiding, trying to not hear. And all of a sudden, what you hear is a... But the only saving grace was when you find the order book, and then you could go to school on Monday and you knew whose mum had a dildo. That was the most powerful document in the school.
Surely they all must have got a dildo.
Not all of them. Karen just went for mainly lingerie.
Oh, did she? Fucking come on, Karen, push the boat
wonderful.
Out. Get the Adonis.
The Adonis?
The Adonis is when they bring out the big guns.
All right. As seen on Eurovision.
OK, so, worst way to spend a Saturday night?
Drowning. That was pretty bad.
It's not what I've got on the card, but it's a very good answer, Rob, yeah.
Worst way to spend a Saturday, is it working?
Mm. It's exactly the right answer.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah. Yes, the worst way to spend a Saturday night is at work. Saturday night is when a lot of people make most of their money. For example, on Saturday nights, your mum can charge double for a gob job. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Kerry, Natasha and Nish have 2 points, Rob, Judy and Fred have 5 points. They're tonight's winners. Thank you to all of our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.